The Patriot Act.
You're calling about making a payment, right?
No.
My mistake. Again, briefly tell me what you're calling about, or say, what are my choices?
The Patriot Act.
Sorry, let's try this a different way. To make changes to your account, including linked cards and bank accounts, say change account info. For security questions, including problems logging in or unknown charges, say password and security issues. For payment status, such as whether a payment has been received or the availability of funds from a payment, say payment status. Or to file a new dispute, escalate a dispute to a claim, or check claim status, say claims and disputes. For anything else, in your own words, tell me what you need.
I'd like to talk to someone regarding the Patriot Act to upgrade my account to business.
Sorry, to make changes to your account, including linked cards and bank accounts, say change account info. For security questions, including problems logging in or unknown chart. I seem to be having some trouble. Let me get someone who can help you. One moment.
Solution Center. A dispute lets you and the seller communicate through the... to resolve the issue.
All of our agents are assisting other callers. Rather than wait on hold, we can call you back when it's your turn within 16 minutes, and you won't lose your place in line. If you'd like us to call you back, press 1. For more options, including how callbacks work, press 2. Sorry, I didn't get that. If you'd like us to call you back, press 1. For more options, including how callbacks work, press 2. To hear how callbacks work, press 1. Or to remain on hold, press 3. Please remain on the line for the next available agent. The current hold time is 16 minutes.
Your password. Common. Including typing your email address incorrectly. Or putting upper or lowercase letters in the wrong places. But just in case you need to, you can always recover your password securely and quickly on our website. Just go to paypal.com and click on the problem with login. Then follow the steps. Remember that for your security, PayPal agents don't have your password and will never ask for it in an email. It's always safest for you to reset your password directly on paypal.com. Shop without revealing your financial information. We keep your bank and credit card details private from sellers. Plus, you are 100% protected against unauthorized payments sent from your account. PayPal is dedicated to helping you stay safe online by avoiding fraudulent emails. Here are a few tips to help you spot suspicious emails. First, PayPal will never ask you for your password or other financial information in an email. If you get an email asking for this information, you can bet it's a fake and you shouldn't respond. Here's another tip. Fake emails usually begin with Dear PayPal User or Dear PayPal Member. An authentic PayPal email will always be by your first and last name or the business name you use with your PayPal account. If the email doesn't include this information, it's a fake. And you can help us catch the bad guys by reporting suspicious email to spoof@paypal.com, and we'll let you know if the email was originally sent from us. Learn more in our Identity Protection resource area at paypal.com/IDProtection. Buy confidently on eBay.com with PayPal. eBay listings that offer PayPal buyer protection, cover your eligible purchases at eBay.com for the full purchase price plus original shipping costs and at no additional cost. If you're shopping on an eBay website outside the U.S., like eBay.ca, look for the buyer protection coverage displayed in the listing. If you'd like to contact eBay, go to eBay.com and click the...
Thank you for waiting. My name is Francis. Can I have your first and last name?
Hi, Francis. This call is being recorded for quality assurance. I was on PayPal. This is Joanna McGrath. I was on PayPal upgrading an account for a friend, and I was upgrading the account to business. And in the process of upgrading the account to business, it came across something regarding the Patriot Act. Can someone explain to me why that's even part of PayPal? Why, when I'm trying to upgrade a business account, why would I have to agree to something regarding the Patriot Act?
By the way, can I have your last name, please?
It's Joanna McGrath, M-A-G-R-A-T-H.
By the way, Joanna, may I ask, how did you place your name under your PayPal account, or how did you register it?
What do you mean?
Because I know what I can see here in my hand, it's under a different last name.
Oh, Joanna Yaley.
All right, take it a bit. Let me just pull up your account, okay? And if I got it correctly, you're inquiring regarding the Patriot Act. Is that correct?
Correct.
All right. Regarding this concern, Joanna, can I please just call on hold for a minute or two? I'm just going to check my tools here in my hand, okay?
Very good.
Thank you. Please stay on the line.
Account adds another layer of protection and tells the people you do business with that you're the real owner of the account. To see whether your account is verified, log into your PayPal account and click See How Much You Can Send with PayPal on the left of the page. If you are not verified, it is as easy as clicking on the link there and following the instructions. Have a question about a recent transaction? Your PayPal account shows a short list of your most recent transactions on the summary page. You can click on the details of any transaction to get the specifics. If you don't see the transaction you are looking for there, click the Activity tab for a complete list.
A little bit about spying and the Patriot Act. There's this provision that was put into the Patriot Act originally, which was called a sneak and peek delayed warrant. And the goal of including this in the Patriot Act was specifically for situations related to terrorism. So this is the scenario that was drawn up as kind of the reason to have the ability to have a sneak and peek delayed warrant. You suspect someone is involved in terrorist activity, but tipping them off to the fact that you're investigating them might make them either act more quickly or it might make them destroy evidence. So this provision says if there is a suspected terrorist or someone who you want to investigate, you can go in and do a sneak and peek to their home or electronically. And this can include taking pictures, smelling, taking measurements, looking at computer files, etc. And only afterwards must they be notified that there was this delayed warrant and that they were sneaked and peeked against. Now, let's be very, very clear. We were told this was for terrorism, but we now have a new report from the Electronic Frontier Foundation, which found, after reviewing reports that were released by the Administrative Office of the U.S. Courts, that only 51 sneak and peek requests during 2013 were actually for terrorism. Now you might say, well, David, 51 out of how many? 51 out of 11,129 total requests. Lewis, if you had to guess, it's not terrorism. What are these sneak and peek delayed warrant requests actually being used to investigate?
Drugs?
Absolutely. Absolutely spot on, Lewis. The numbers, this is a quote from Mark Jaycox at the EFF, the numbers vindicate privacy advocates who urged Congress to shelve this section during the Patriot Act debates. Proponents of this section claimed sneak and peek warrants were needed to protect against terrorism, but just like we've seen elsewhere, these claims were false. Yet another way, Lewis, in which the eagerness of the American people post 9/11 to accept almost anything that might even have a small chance of keeping them safer, understandably, we're not criticizing anyone for this, has been used to prop up and further the failed, pathetic, and embarrassing...
Sorry, go ahead.
Regarding the Patriot Act, I'm going to connect to one of our account specialists so that they can further explain to you and also give you an overview of what is the Patriot Act. But apparently, the department that I'm going to connect you now is already closed. So what I highly suggest is that if you can give us a call back tomorrow, and don't worry, I'll just place a note on your account of what we talked about so that the next agent that will receive your call will redirect you to the right department.
Right department tonight or tomorrow?
Tomorrow.
So someone's...
That department that I'm going to connect you is already closed.
Okay, so someone's going to call me back tomorrow.
No, you can give us a call back tomorrow.
Oh, I'm going to call y'all back tomorrow. Is there a number or anything that I should use?
Yes, there is. I can give you our number. Let me just check my tool here. Our number is 888-221-1161.
Now, do I use the one-time passcode that I have here, or am I going to use another number?
Yes, you can still use the one-time passcode.
Okay, so you have no clue why they're asking me to agree to something regarding the Patriot Act?
Yes, that department that I'm supposedly to connect, supposedly to transfer to connect you, they can explain it further for you.
All right, so on my account, is there something marked or tagged or labeled with regards to my acceptance to the Patriot Act?
Regarding that concern, Joanna, I really can't answer that because or the department that they should transfer, they should be the one who can answer that for you and also give you a good overview.
All right, I'll call somebody tomorrow, but if I don't like it, I'm going to cancel my PayPal account and tell y'all to go pound tar. Have a good evening.
Have a good evening, ma'am.
Well, I'll make that call to PayPal first thing in the morning, but I wanted to finish out this
video. War on drugs. There is a direct connection now that we can see between 9/11 through the Patriot Act into the war on drugs and the incarceration of nonviolent drug offenders. This is so embarrassing.
And, you know, I bet right now there are a lot of people in Canada that are looking at this situation and thinking to themselves, we can't let this happen up here.
I hope they are, because as we talked about, Prime Minister Stephen Harper in Canada, in the wake of the Ottawa shooting, which tragically did lead to a casualty, they are now trying to fast-track the expansion of spying powers and police powers. Just look at what happened here. Lies about the number of thwarted terror attacks, a 99% usage that is not terrorism related of a provision that was meant specifically to fight terror. They should be paying very close attention, Lewis, to these reports.
Definitely. I have a hard time imagining the exact same type of legislation happening in Canada, but you never know.
Well,
let's talk a little bit about...
Alrighty then. So, I don't know. I don't know what to make of all this. So, I don't see anything with regards to the Patriot Act and PayPal and why, regarding a business account, you would have to accept a passage to accept the Patriot Act to upgrade your account to business. So, I don't know. I don't see any more. So, we'll do a part two tomorrow. Take care.
There's an expired credit card on your account. If you'd like to take care of that now, say update expiration date. Otherwise, in a couple of words, tell me what you're calling about. You can say things like, with my teeth, or I can't access my account. These are just examples. So tell me why you're calling.
The Patriot Act.
You're calling about a statement-related issue, is that right?
No, I'm calling about the Patriot Act.
Sorry, please say yes or no. You're calling about a statement-related issue, is that right? My mistake. Again, briefly tell me what you're calling about, or say, they're my choices.
The Patriot Act. And then for you guys checking in, today is October 17th, 11:35 a.m.
To make changes to your account, including linked cards and bank accounts, say change account info. For security questions, including... I still didn't get that. Say change account info, password and security issues, payment status. I seem to be having some trouble. Let me get someone who can help you. One moment.
If you'd like to contact eBay, go to ebay.com and click the customer support link located in the upper right-hand corner. When you do, you can search for an answer or contact an eBay customer support representative by clicking on the Contact eBay tab. Update your account or financial information is on our website. Open a browser and log in to your account at paypal.com. Then, click the settings icon at the top of the page. Find the area you're looking for and select the item you want to add, edit, or update. You can update credit cards, expiration dates, phone numbers, and more. Center is where buyers and sellers request assistance to resolve issues like disputes, chargebacks, appeals, and limited account access. You can also use it to respond to or check the status of your open.
I'm going to pause it here. Let me pick up. I'll come back on. Good morning, Kelly. My name is Joanna McGrath, and this call is being recorded for quality assurance.
Okay.
And it's also under Joanna McGrath, or Joanna Yaley, excuse me, on my PayPal account.
Okay. And what can I help you with?
I had called last night. I had a client, well, really not even a client, a friend that wanted to upgrade their PayPal account. And because they wanted to put a donation button on their website. And so when I went to help them upgrade their account to so they could get the donation button, we had to upgrade the account to a business account. And then in the process of updating it to a business account, they asked you a few questions, and one of them that kind of took me off guard is, why would PayPal insert the Patriot Act onto the acceptance of a business upgrade?
Because PayPal is required by law to meet those standards.
What standards?
The Patriot Act standards.
Do you know what those standards are?
As they apply to OFAC, I can transfer to you to the department that can give you more information, but I do know that we're required for customers to meet OFAC standards. But like I said, I can get you over to a department that has more information on that.
What is OFAC? How do you spell that?
OFAC, O-F-A-C.
Again,
I can transfer you to the department that would have more information on that.
Very good. Thank you.
Hang on just one second.
I appreciate it. Jurisdiction.
Until it gets resolved. Third, if you are still unable to resolve the problem, you can escalate the dispute to a claim, and we'll look into the case and decide the outcome. To file a dispute or escalate to a claim, log into your PayPal account and click the Resolution Center link. Did you know we have detailed tutorials for the disputes and claims processes on PayPal.com? You can find them by logging into your PayPal account and clicking the tutorials link in the Resolution Center. Let's face it, it's not always easy to remember your password. Common mistakes, including typing your email address incorrectly, leaving the caps lock on, or putting upper or lowercase letters in the wrong places. But just in case you need to, you can always recover your password securely and quickly on our website. Just go to paypal.com and click on the problem with login. Then follow the steps. Remember that for your security, PayPal agents don't have your password and will never ask for it in an email. It's always safest for you to reset your password directly on paypal.com.
Committees. Latest action. Roll calls. Notes.
With PayPal, you can shop without revealing your financial information. We keep your bank and credit card details private from sellers. Plus, you are 100% protected against unauthorized payments sent from your account.
Express assent of Congress that, one, the civil rights and liberties of all Americans, including Arab Americans, must be protected, and that every effort must be taken to preserve their safety. Any acts of violence or discrimination against any Americans be condemned. Any acts of violence or discrimination against any Americans be condemned, and the nation is called upon to recognize the patriotism of fellow citizens from all ethnic, racial, and religious backgrounds. can help authorizes appropriations for the Federal Bureau of Investigation, FBI Technical Support Center.
And we'll let you know if the email was originally sent from us. Learn more in our Identity Protection resource area at paypal.com/IDProtection. Buy confidently on eBay.com with PayPal. eBay listings that offer PayPal buyer protection cover your eligible purchases at eBay.com for the full purchase price plus original shipping costs and at no additional cost. If you're shopping on an eBay website outside the U.S., like eBay.ca, look for the buyer protection coverage displayed in the listing.
Feel free to stop us at any given time.
eBay.com and click the customer support link located in the upper right-hand corner. When you do, you can search for an
amends the trade sanctions reform and export enhancement act of 2000 to extend trade sanctions to the territory of Afghanistan controlled by the Taliban. Oh my God. Anyway, so international money laundering.
The fastest way to update your account or financial information is on our website. Open a browser and log in to your account at paypal.com. Then click the settings icon at the top of the page. Find the area you're looking for and select the item you want to add, edit, or update. You can update credit cards, expiration dates, phone numbers, and more.
Subjects to mandatory records and reports.
The resolution
monitoring
where buyers and sellers request assistance.
Any licensed sender
like dispute
of money,
chargeback,
any
appeals,
and
limited
in
account access.
Business
you can also use it to respond to or check the status of or open disputes and claims. To visit the resolution center, log into your PayPal account and click Resolve a Problem in our resolution center at the left of the page. PayPal account adds another layer of protection and tells the people you do business with that you are the real owner of the account. To see whether your account is verified, log into your PayPal account and click See How Much You Can Send with PayPal on the left of the page. If you are not verified, it is as easy as clicking on the link there and following the instructions. Question about a recent transaction? Your PayPal account shows a short list of your most recent transactions on the summary page. You can click on the details of any transaction to get the specifics. If you don't see the transaction you're looking for there, click the Activity tab for a complete list.
All your online information, one place, one source. What the frick do they need all of our information for?
eBay gift certificates
and OFAC sanction list.
You share
I'm like,
the
come on.
Of bidding and buying on eBay. You can buy them securely with PayPal. Send them via email or print them out to deliver yourself. The choice is yours. There's something for everyone on eBay, so take the guesswork out of gift giving. And give the gift of eBay. Look for the link to gift certificates and gift cards in the lower section of the...
We're PayPal. We're the government. We're going to take your money. We're going to control your account. We're going to tell you what you can and can't buy. I'm going to pause it so you're going to listen, keep listening to this nonsensical music.
First and last name.
Hello, Sandra. This is Joanna Yaley. This call is being recorded for quality assurance.
Okay, and are you with the bank, Joanna?
The bank?
Yeah, or can I ask the reason regarding the call being recorded? It's just we're not allowed to give out permission for calls to be recorded, so if you don't mind.
The call is being recorded because I'm questioning why PayPal wants me to authorize an account with regards to the Patriot Act. Why there would be even such a question to upgrade an account to business and then put in the Patriot Act.
Okay, Joanna, so that's your question today?
Correct.
Okay. So just bear with me one moment. Okay, Joanna, I'm just going to pop you on a quick call, so just bear with me for one moment, okay?
All right. Put it on pause again until they come back, I guess. I am still on hold with PayPal, since nobody wants to talk about the Patriot Act. So I'm going to end the call, and I will do a part two on this. But you can come to this website right here and look at the Patriot Act, the U.S. Patriot Act, and go through each of the tabs through here. Take care.